Hey everyone, my name is Kajal. Welcome to this channel. Today's video is a tutorial on Webots, a robotic simulation software. In this tutorial, we will go over download, installation, and some basic concepts to get you started with using Webots. I have included all of the timings here and in the description below. So without further ado, let's get into it. We'll start by going to the Cyberbotics website, and you can see that it automatically detects that I'm on Ubuntu and I'm able to download it. I've already downloaded this and you can see it on my desktop. What I did next was simply double clicked on this, which opened up the Ubuntu software windows, and then by clicking on install, I was able to install the software. I've already done this step, so next is to open it up. I opened a new terminal and simply typed Webots. So here we go. Now some basic concepts. Up here you can see the simulation has already started. So a good thing to do when you always start is hit pause and then also do a reset. Now given that we are starting, we'll start with a new project. You can do this by going into the options menu, wizards and new project directory. You can name your project whatever you want. I'm going with my project. And then start with an empty world. A good thing to do is add the rectangular arena, which will help you get started. As you can see, the world has loaded with a rectangular arena, essentially a floor with four walls. So one thing you should do is learn how to zoom in and zoom out. This is simply done by scrolling in and out. Another thing is you can click on it and you can move it around to look at different views. On the left side, you have your scene tree, essentially all the paths that will go into your world. And with this option, you are able to change different aspects as well as add new things. So for example, we can change our floor size to be 10 by 10. And as you can see, our arena has grown tenfold in size. We can always change it back to 1 by 1. Let's create an object of our own. We will first go over the steps to create an object, and then we will take time to understand what each of those elements mean. So let's click on the rectangular arena and then click on the plus sign. This will allow us to add a new object. Now objects in Webots are essentially nodes. You can use proto nodes, which are essentially prototypes, or you can create a new one for yourself. So let's start by creating a new one for ourselves, which is under the section base nodes. We're going to start with solid. After clicking under solid, we will go under children and add another shape. Next, within shape, we will make a sphere. Double click on geometry. And you should be able to see different shapes. Let's start with a sphere. Click on add. Now all the objects are added at 000. By clicking on the geometry, we are able to change the dimensions. So we could go from 0.1 to 0.05, and you can see the sphere has reduced half in its size. Next comes appearance. Let's use base node PBR appearances. Click on add. Within appearances, you have multiple options. With base color, you can change the color. So let's make our ball red in color. Next, let's change the roughness to 1 and the metalness to 0. So with that, we created our first object. We need to do more things to be able to make it usable. Next, we have to change the bounding object. This is going to be the same thing as your shape. So now instead of having to do it all over again, you can reuse the same shape. So click on shape and using def, name it something that you can reuse. So let's call it ball. Now on your bounding object, when you double click, you can click on use to use this shape that we just created, which in this case is ball. Lastly, let's add physics. So in this case, it's just a simple physics. This helps with things like gravity. And as you go into more advanced projects, you can change this for different features. Now that was a lot, so let's do a quick recap on how to create an object in Webots. We first start with a solid node, which represents a rigid body. Simply click on the plus icon and then go into base node, solid, to create a solid node. Next, we add a child node in similar fashion and select shape. Under shape, we use geometry to choose our shape. In this case, we chose a sphere. We can further modify different parameters such as radius to change the size of our object. Next, we change the appearance. We click on appearance and select PBR appearance as a base node. With this node, we can change color, roughness, metalness, and other features. Now we want the ability to reuse this shape. So we use def to define it as an object. Next, we give it a bounding object. In this case, we reuse the shape we just defined. The bounding object essentially defines the collision bounds for our object. Lastly, we add physics. This makes our object dynamic. Compared to the rectangular arena, which is static, our object would be dynamic, meaning it would have the ability to move around. Now our ball is kind of in the floor, so let's lift it up a little bit. You can use translation to change it. Let's raise it a meter above the floor. Now that's too much. So how about 200 centimeters? There you go. You can always use the save option to keep saving your work. Now as you can see, the ball is way above the floor. Now let's run the simulation by clicking on run. As you can see, it just dropped on the floor, which is to be expected given the gravity. It did not go through the floor because floor is static. You can always reset your simulation by clicking on reset. So that's an object that you created. You can also always use pre-existing objects and robots. So for example, let's create a new one by clicking on the plus sign. Going on to proto nodes, robots, GCstronic, epoch, and then add. Now as we play a simulation, the robot continues to drive. Let's pause the simulation. So again, click on the plus sign. This time, let's go into proto nodes, robots, GCtronic, epoch, and click on add. It plays the robot again at 000. Now to ensure the ball doesn't hit the robot, let's move it a little bit. We moved it 200 centimeters in the X direction. Red it is X, blue is Y, and Z is green. Let's save. Let's run the simulation. As you can see, the robot has started moving around. This is because this robot comes with its own controller. So let's pause the simulation to see what's going on. Under the epoch, you can see controller. And when I double click on it, I can see epoch avoid obstacles. This is the main program that's running the robot right now. You can always change it to run your own software such that the epoch will behave in a way you want it. When I click on edit, I'm able to see the software. This code is written in C. Webots supports C, C++, and even Python, so you can write in whichever language you prefer. This is a basic code to drive the robot around while avoiding obstacles. If you want to change behavior, you can either edit this file or create your own file and simply change it under the controller tab. So those are some basic concepts of Webot. In the next tutorial, we will build our own robot and drive it around. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe.